million tourist arrivals come 2016. Is that 2016 or 2013? Tony, go ahead.
All right. Well, thank you very much, Tina. The Tourism Secretary, Juan Jimenez, joins us now here at our live spot at the Batasan. So good afternoon, Mr. Secretary.
Thank you, Tony. Nice to be here. Mm-hmm.
Well, special mention for you and the other cabinet officials for your role in improving the government's performance in the field of tourist arrivals. President, particularly happy that what we had in 2012 supposed to be for tourist arrivals, much better than what the previous administration had, expecting more tourist arrivals. How exactly are you, how confident are you that that's going to be met?
Well, again, Tony, I must emphasize that tourism, the work of building up tourism comes in several parts. Now, the most obvious one is building demand. And demand creation, I must tell you, is the easiest part of what I do.
Okay.
The fact of the matter is, the Philippines' biggest problem was not its bad image. Mm-hmm. This is a misconception. All the research you can look at will tell you the primary reason for the sluggishness of tourism before was there was very little information. It was plain, simple ignorance about the country.
Really?
So demand creation can, in fact, be done. Mm-hmm. And in short order, as you can see.
Okay.
And our capacity to absorb that demand is going to be the key in the next few years.
Mm. Now, tourists would want to come to a country that can guarantee their safety, that can offer convenience, whether you're traveling around a country or eating or sleeping. And all the infrastructure that the government is putting in place, is that going to be helpful to at least the tourism promotion of the Philippines?
Oh, absolutely. But like I tell everyone, to be very frank, nobody builds ahead of the demand. Mm-hmm. Okay, not government, not private investors. And it's only now that we've been building up the demand. So my advice to everyone is we're going to go through a period of about a year and a half of a very tight squeeze.
Okay.
So we're going to have to muster as much fun as we can gather.
Okay.
But when the infrastructure, when the work on infrastructure starts coming out of the hopper, as soon as it comes on stream, then you're going to see even greater acceleration.
Mm. Because the president was talking about all the provincial airports that are already in the pipeline, that are going to be completed at least within the next 2 years. Also talking about the road infrastructure that will make it easier to travel from north to south Luzon.
Exactly.
But apart from that, what are we actually going to offer to tourists who come here to see and to enjoy?
Well, the National Tourism Development Plan breaks the country up into clusters and therefore disciplines the development of key areas. It's not going to be randomized anymore. It's not going to be dependent on who's got the loudest voice, etc. It's going to be very neatly clustered around key gateways. And that's why the infrastructure you were talking about is very important.
Yeah.
Because the areas of development initially will be those most proximate to a gateway. Mm-hmm. And the infrastructure we will build to interconnect all these touristic sites to the gateway becomes very critical, very important. Mm-hmm. So you are going to see a build-up towards the 10 million.
Mm-hmm. And we're talking about building more tourist arrivals, and that should generate more jobs locally for the tourism industry.
Oh, yes. You know, even today, 2011, we ended with 3.9 million. That accounted for about 3.4 million jobs, almost one-to-one. So theoretically, if you get to 10 million, the estimate places it at direct employment only.
Yeah.
Does not include the other businesses that come on or downstream.
Mm.
It's almost 8 million jobs and about close to 12% of GDP.
Mm-hmm. But does that also factor in how our national policy is vis-a-vis the budget air carriers that come into the Philippines? I mean, how are we affected by, you know, sometimes the what they call the unfair practices maybe of these budget carriers?
Well, again, I wouldn't call them unfair practices. Picture this.
Okay.
We are growing at a faster clip, tourism-wise, than most of our neighbors. It's the same as the economy, okay? We've got a lot of lessons to learn along the way. Nobody predicted this. Nobody predicted that Boracay would now be up to almost 1.5 million visitors a year. Mm. These are very, very serious problems that we have to transform into opportunities. But hey, you know, even pressure is more fun in the Philippines. So.
All right, Tina, do you have any questions for Tourism Secretary Jimenez?
Just say hi to him. I need to go on a break. Thank you very much, Secretary Mon Jimenez.
Email me. I can recommend about 12 places.
Okay, wow. I'll do that. Okay. I'll take you up on that. Thank you very much, Tony. We'll get back to you. We'll have one more break, the final stretch of this special coverage when we return.